Doing another video today. This one's going to be not as candid, not as straight, like I did with the video on CM Punk tweet war with Chris Brown. By the way, Punk, you got my backing on this, but this is a subject that we're now going to go on to. We've touched upon this so many times on Raw Down Rebound, and even Random DCE has kind of touched upon this.
Yeah.
WWE, why the hell are you still keeping Johnny Ace on camera? I mean, if the guy's good at what he does behind the scenes and only behind the scenes, then, you know, are you really that stuck for ideas in terms of talent, quote unquote, that you have to put in a guy who botches more than Mike Adamley?
Yeah, I mean, like, I know what they're trying to do. I know exactly what they're trying to do. They want to recreate that sort of flair and hatred that the fans have for Mr. McMahon. But the difference is, Mr. McMahon is entertaining. He's funny. You know, he really, really sells it. I mean, you know, let's compare a Vince McMahon promo to a Johnny Ace promo. You know, Vince McMahon music hits, he BMFs down to the ring, shoulders going. He gets in the ring, he mentions where they are, in his big, big scary voice. He talks about his opponent in a derogatory or patronizing way. He puts them down, he brags about being a billionaire. And then, you know, if he's firing somebody, he throws in the classic, "You're fired." And the presence he gives off, his word use, the way he talks down to the audience, it's entertaining to watch, no matter what he's saying. You may hate what he's saying, but you will agree that you watch it and it entertains you. You know, it's just like, that's the kind of presence you know, a villain needs. Let's compare that to Johnny Ace. Johnny Ace comes out, he begins every single promo with the same fucking line of, you know, "My name is blah 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 blah." It's like, he's pretty much like a toy that has a pull string. And it's stuck on that one, you know, message.
Or
it's like, right, this is for RPG fans. It's like, you know, you walk into a random town of an RPG, and you always talk to that NPC character, and they always say the same thing. That's Johnny Ace. He says the exact same thing. Like, seriously, can someone, like, go and watch when he first debuted as, you know, the chief, whatever it is.
Chief Vice Executive President of Talent Relations. Oh, good lord!
Yeah, watch every single Raw, SmackDown, or pay-per-view he's been on. How many times has he said that in his run?
And notice he doesn't have music.
Yeah, so, you know, he comes to the ring, he gets in the ring, and in his, you know, suffering with, you know, laryngitis voice, you know, something about, I want to be fair, I want to be impartial. I mean, it has that classic, like, Vince McMahon hypocrisy, but again, it's why I said Vince McMahon is entertaining. You know, he can sell it. I mean, there are so many classic lines Vince has once said. I mean, just to throw a couple out there. "I will strike down the face of defiance. Life sucks and then you die." You know, what else is it? The hell are your values?
Or like, my balls are the size of grapefruits.
"You're fired." And the, you know, "Praise be the name of Vincent Kennedy." How many memorable lines does Johnny Ace have? You know, he just has the, "My name is John Garnett," and that's it.
And of course, the in-joke on RDO. "I sent a text. How am I doing?"
Comparing Vince McMahon to fucking Johnny Ace, right, is like comparing Count Dracula to Bob from Earthworm Jim.
Ew.
You know, that goldfish?
Oh, La Nopla de Agua.
Good shit. I mean, it's just, that's the problem. It's just because they want to make him Vince McMahon. Because if you notice, for a while, they were trying that CM Punk versus Johnny Ace and try and rekindle, like, Austin versus McMahon. But the problem is, you know, it takes two to tango.
I mean, Punk is doing more than his bit.
You know, Punk is doing good. I mean, if you want to call him a modern Stone Cold, I mean, personally, I don't, because, you know, no one should be compared to Stone Cold. And that's why we don't need a modern-day Stone Cold. We don't need a modern-day Rock. We need our own thing. That's why we don't need a modern-day Hulk Hogan, even though they give us John Cena. But the problem is, like, you know, I don't watch wrestling as much as you do anymore. But, like, Johnny Ace is killing it. I mean, you could say that, you know, John Cena's bad, you could say Mark Henry's bad, you could say Daniel Bryan's bad, or Michael Cole, but no! This motherfucker is, if he becomes the permanent manager of both shows, I'm not watching it anymore, because, you know, I'm actually seriously considering watching SmackDown, because I know he's not gonna be there! But, oh, wait, he was there this week as well. fuck.
I mean, you know, every time, he's been featured more times on Botchamania than CZW.
I don't know what that is.
It's like indie wrestling.
Oh, okay. But it's just, like, the problem is, it's like, I know what they're trying to do. It's just like, yeah, we've been over this, but we know what they're doing, but it's not working because this guy has no mic skills. He has no charisma, he has no talent, like, he hasn't been properly, I can tell he's not been trained, you know, to read this shit out. I get the sense, like, if they want to just, like, I think what WWE needs to do is they need to start using self-aware humor, because sometimes when you're doing bad, if you throw in a bit of self-aware humor, it actually becomes, it's like some people actually say that Sonic games have been bad, they start doing this like self-aware humor saying, yeah, we know, yeah, it's shit, but we know it's shit.
I mean,
this one bit where Robotnik says something like, I think it's in Sonic Colors, and he goes, and I will rule the world. He turns to the camera and says, yes, I know I say that every single time, but this time I mean it.
I'll give you an example of WWE doing this one time. Steph botched a promo awards for the Slammies in 2009. And then after she botched it, goes, oh, I pulled an Adam Lee.
Yeah. What they need to do is, I mean, what would really win Johnny Ace for me if they just started doing it? Like, one week he just comes out and he's holding a clipboard. And he's reading it out and he goes, my name is John Laurinaitis. And I am the, turn to page 2, Chief Vice. They just start throwing it in, like, it's like, yeah, I know I'm a douche, but, you know, that's the point.
I mean, Triple H.
Well, this fucker, he plays it so straight-faced, you know, like, oh, I want you to like me. I want you to like me. We're not going to like you. You got more chance of us liking John Cena.
Ooh.
You got more chance of us liking Michael Cole. You've got more chance of liking if Jonathan Coachman came back. And I want Jonathan Coachman back. He was entertaining. Say what you want about Coach, but I liked seeing him. He was funny.
I know.
Watching him getting his ass kicked was fun. Seeing CM Punk, you know, doing the GTS on Jonathan, it was fun because he didn't even change facial expression.
I know. Botchamania described it as the thinker.
I mean, I could watch Johnny Ace being shot and I would get no pleasure from it. It's like, oh, that was kind of dull. Because I imagine when he dies, he has the same facial expression. Like, oh, my name is John Laurinaitis and I'm dead. Oh, okay.
You know,
keep this fucker behind the curtain. Don't wheel him out on Raw.
You know, This is, you know, WWE, particularly with Raw's situation, is so bad, I actually miss Vicky Guerrero as the GM.
No, I actually miss when fucking Eric Bischoff and Paul Heyman ran the show. And you say what you want about Bischoff or, you know, what about Paul Heyman.
But they were entertaining.
But they had some decent fucking matches. I mean, the Undertaker versus Vince McMahon buried alive match was epic. I love that match.
Or, I mean, and you argue with Bischoff, I mean, Raw Roulette.
Elimination Chamber? Although that he did a lot of questionables. I mean, that stupid HLA thing was dumb. Because you knew damn well they would never get away with that. And I do not condone when he did the 3-minute
warning. No, 3-minute warning.
I mean,
warning,
doing 3-minute warning to guys like Ric Flair and whatnot, people who can fight back, fair enough. But if you're going to do it to people, when you try doing that shit to classy Freddy Blassie.
Yeah, that
it's
was...
like, come on, dude. I mean, there's controversy making cash and they're just being a cunt, you know?
I mean, it's actually the same with that, and, you know, I mean, Mike Adamley might have botched like crazy, but at least the guy was semi-likable. I mean,
yeah.
He came up with some interesting ideas. Shut up, Wade.
It's just like, what would really sell it for me, what would really, you know, make me prick my ears up and take notice again, right, this is what needs to be done, we need proper matches. I mean, I don't mean the stupid, like, oh, look, it's, what's his name? Jinder Mahal?
Jinder Mahal. Oh, he's pissing me off.
It's not him I'm angry at or what I'm pissed off at. I'm getting pissed off that they have these matches. A guy comes out, it's like, yeah, I'm here. And this other guy comes out, squashes him, 3 minutes, and it's over. And Sheamus, would it really kill you to learn some wrestling moves?
Well, at least he can actually wrestle better than Cena, and that's saying something.
Yeah, I mean, I'm sick and tired of, like, watching Sheamus just punching. If I wanted to see somebody punch and kick someone, I'd go and play Street Fighter. You know, that's what it's there for. This is world wrestling. I know they hate that word, But this is World Wrestling Entertainment. And ever since they attached that fucking E to that acronym, it's not been watchable.
I mean, and the other thing is, Ted DiBiase versus Hunico. I mean, it's getting tedious every single week.
Yeah, it's just like, so we need some proper matches. I mean, I'm probably going to offend some of it, but what's the point of having a Divas division when only one of them can actually wrestle? Which is, I think it's Beth Phoenix. You know what?
That and Natalya.
Well, I haven't really, I don't really pay much.
And it's like what we've been saying on RDR, don't have her fart.
I mean, I don't know what that's about, so I'm just going to look at that. I'm just going to just look at that and just think, yeah, okay, that sounds dumb. But it's like, don't, I mean, why do we need general managers? I mean, what we really need is, get rid of Teddy Long, get rid of Johnny Ace, and just, even I don't care if he's really getting old, have Vince just come out there and run the fucking show again.
Or heck, bring back the WWE commissionership.
Yeah, that was, just have one guy in charge. Don't let it be, because let's face it, don't let it be Johnny Ace. I mean,
oh,
because,
no.
You know, he is the thing that is killing WWE for me, because it's just, I can't, and Teddy Long, I mean, yeah, he's been doing quite well, but his solution to everything is a tag match.
I know. Hold up just a second, player.
I am dreading, like, if SmackDown does a wedding show, this is exactly what's going to happen. The Reverend's going to say, let's just say for sake of argument, it's a marriage between, I don't know, Drew McIntyre and Eve Torres. Just for sake of argument, alright? So they're in the ring, yeah, they do all that sort of stuff, and the Vicar goes, probably Shawn Michaels actually, and he goes, now if there's anyone here who shows any reason why these two should not be joined in holy matrimony, speak now or forever hold your peace. Suddenly you hear, hold on just a minute there, players! These two cannot be married until they compete in a tag match! Now how's that, player? They're looking like, what the fuck? What you need is, like, this is why I miss Shane McMahon. Because, you know, when you had the dynamic duo of Vince and Shane, you knew shit was going to be entertaining.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, say what you want about Shane, you know, Simba, or, you know, Spawn of Satan, Satan Jr., or this, you know, the Shane Shuffle, whatever it's called. I mean, say what you want, but that was entertaining. I've been recently rewatching that DX DVD. And with Vince and Shane, it was watchable! Now, I know people said that DX era was kind of bad, but I got that.
I think it was in Pro Wrestling Illustrated Newsletter 06, they voted DX versus the McMahons as the worst storyline of the year.
I'll say what you want, but it had some decent promos and matches. But the problem is, it's like, there's none of that dichotomy anymore. All we've got now is Johnny Ace. There's no good faces apart from CM Punk. Heels that, they're not even worth hating. I mean, you've got Mark Henry, who's just a slab of, like, beef that's been left out in the sun too long, and it's starting to really pong. You've got Daniel, you know, yes! Yes! Bryan, who, let's face it, is not really, there's nothing there.
I mean, like, wrestling-wise, he's amazing.
He should have a t-shirt that says, I'm a heel because the writers say so.
Yeah.
And, you know, and just by saying that, John Cena should have a t-shirt that says, I'm a face because the writers say so. But on the back it just says, but you all think I'm a cunt.
Mm.
Yeah, if Cena had a t-shirt like that, I would give him respect. You've got Mark Henry, who's bland as all hell. You've got Daniel Bryan, who's bland as all hell. You've got Alberto Del Rio, who has the markings to be a good heel, but they don't properly utilize him. Mm. It's just like, he comes out and he's like, I'm from Mexico! I have cars! And I'm just sitting there going, and? It's like, I am reminded of JBL with that guy, but they don't, say what you want about JBL, but he was worth hating.
Oh yeah.
You know, he actually had an in-ring presence and an in-ring prowess that, you're thinking, yeah, I want to hate this guy, because he wins.
And of course, there was that infamous GIF image over the internet of him doing the goose step.
Yeah, but at least JBL didn't just pull a Daniel Bryan and go, oh, I'm going to walk away. At least he, you know, fought the matches.
Yeah.
You know, even though he won or lost, he still fought. He didn't do this, oh, I'm going to leave the ring now. Yes, yes, yes. You got Christian, who's basically reminding me of Bret Hart, because he's whining he got screwed.
If he
whines as much as he complains, he would have struck oil by now. I know you're thinking
that. It's true.
You had Kevin Nash. I don't know where the fuck they were going with that. That's over now. Injured again. You got the Black Spider, Sin Cara. I don't know what happened to that.
Well, Sin Cara Azul.
Yeah.
Apparently legitimate injury.
Alright.
And then you got Hunico, bland as all hell.
What other heels have we got? See, that's it. I mean, I can't think of a
Ziggles.
he doesn't really... He's just like a showpiece. You've got The Miz, who is just a Chris Jericho wannabe. You've got Chris Jericho, the human Christmas tree. You got R-Truth, who is just starting to remind me a lot of Johnny 2x4 from Ed, Ed and Eddie.
Oh, dear.
If he just comes out with Plank next week, the image would be complete.
This is Little Jimmy!
I mean, from the Attitude Era, I mean, on one hand, you could name five decent heels from the Attitude Era.
Triple H.
Undertaker, Vince McMahon, Shane McMahon, and Kane.
Yeah.
And just to throw in a couple more, you got DX, you had... Who else was a good heel from that era?
Rock was a really good heel.
Yeah, Rock was a good heel. Mankind was a good heel at one point. When you can do the corporate dude love. You had Patterson and Briscoe.
The Stooges.
Oh yeah, you had Badass Billy Gunn, Road Dogg, New Age Outlaws. You had X-Pac, you had... Tori, was that her name? The Big Green Machine.
Yeah.
Yeah. Look, we named about 10 heels in the Attitude Era. We could barely struggle to come up with 10 from the modern era.
I know.
There's just nothing in WWE anymore. That's the problem, because this is why I miss WCW. Because, you know, when WCW existed, there was competition, there was conflict. Because now that it's just WWE, I mean, let's face it, TNA is just a joke. TNA will never be in WWE's league.
Yeah, but having said that, Razor Fist said that TNA's ratings are slowly catching up with WWE.
Yeah, because people are getting fed up. It's like, I can't watch this anymore. It's like Martin Houston. I can't put up with this shit. So I'm going to go watch some other shit that's even shittier. Because this shit is too shitty. I think what needs to happen is WCW needs to come back. Because, I mean, I know people are saying, no, fuck that shit. But at least, like I said, the Monday Night Wars, you know, that was when wrestling was at its peak.
Well, you know, Eric Bischoff said it the best. He made Vince McMahon change his business strategy. And it's come to that time...
Again, where it needs to happen again. We need to see another Monday Night War. And let's face it, if let me put it this way, right? If WCW came back and had the kind of the pinnacle it had when the NWO first formed, you had about like, what, 95, 96?
It was 96 when they first formed.
So if you had the WCW of 96 versus the WWE of today, WCW would kick the fucking crap out of WWE without even trying.
I know.
Because people would rather watch the NWO than, oh, I'm Johnny Eggs, I feed on your brains. You know what? That voice reminds you of a cross between the principal from Beavis and Butt-head, that first zombie you hear in House of
Dead. Yeah. That's why we call him Principal Ace.
It's just, that's what put me off. It's just like, there's no Vince, no Shane, no Stone Cold,
no
Rock, no...
Well, sparingly.
No Mick Foley. I mean, DX is gone, and I think for good this time. No Outlaws, no Dudleys. Edge and Christian, that's all packed up now. Hardy Boys, can't say I fucking miss them, to be honest. Kind of a rumour going around that Matt Hardy committed suicide.
No, it's not true.
Yeah, I guess that's why I said a rumour. There's no Mean Street Posse.
I know.
They were funny as fuck. No TNA, no Trish, no Lita. Well, not sure about that last one. Tori just vanished. Both of them. Stacy vanished. JR's gone.
Yeah, and another thing, the way they keep picking on JR on camera and off camera, it's like, why have you got to do this to this guy? He was
there.
He's the best play-by-play announcer. You take here's a good example. WrestleMania 27 last year. You remove Michael Cole from the announcing position, put JR back with the King, the pay-per-view suddenly took a life on its own. Yeah,
and even when JR was not there, they had this dichotomy between the King and Joey Styles. And that was, Joey Styles was pretty good.
And the thing is,
and then Joey Styles left, and apparently he works on the website now.
I mean, with Joey Styles, he wanted just to be able to do his commentating and announce it, but they said, no, we want you to tell stories, we don't want you to call a wrestling match. And he's like,
But it's a wrestling match. That's
exactly.
What, that's what it is. I mean, it's like I said, I don't know where I said this, but this is WWE, this is not a fucking episode of Coronation Street.
Exactly.
You know, although even though
CM Punk was like Kevin Webster.
Go in for yourself. But I mean, my point, this is kind of like evolved past Johnny Ace now. We're just talking about WWE now. And like, you know, I got into WWE around like 2000. I think the Royal Rumble was the very first pay-per-view I ever saw. And
I mean, I got into it late 99. Friend of mine showed me, Hell Yeah, Austin's third home title. And, you know, Austin is the reason that I continue to watch wrestling today.
Stone Cold, I think, is the reason a lot of people got it. If you ask somebody, like, what got you into wrestling, WWE or WWF, they'll probably say to you either two names, either Hulk Hogan or Stone Cold.
Yeah.
Although I know someone like Emma would probably say Macho Man or maybe a guy.
Yeah!
Oh, miss you, by the way, Macho
I'm
Man.
In the danger zone. What's going to happen down the pike?
Down the pike! It's just like, I know he's dead, but it's just so many memorable quotes there.
I know.
But like, the thing is, like, we listed a bunch of names, like Hulk Hogan, you know, Randy Savage, Stone Cold, and, you know, like, none of the people in the ring now have that kind of presence. I mean,
no.
Like, if Hogan appeared in front of a WWE crowd, he would get nothing but cheers. Maybe you hear some boos, but, like, what have we got? I mean, you have Sheamus, doesn't get much of a reaction. You've got Randy Orton, who is basically a T-1000 with half of the personality.
But he can wrestle a hell of a match.
Yeah, but, like, I've said this a lot offline, but I'm going to say this in the video so you can all hear me say it. If he's got voices in his head, I've got a whole fucking orchestra in mind, but...
I believe Helsing920 said best, Helsing just messaged me, I hear voices in my head, then get that looked at, you boring cunt.
It's true, because it's like, Randy Orton is, I mean, that's why I'm really glad that him and Orton, or sorry, him and Cena have not been pushing for the belts, because for a while, it, you know, Raw and SmackDown became the Cena and Orton show.
And before that, it was the Cena and Edge show.
Yeah, but Edge was entertaining. You know, the R ain't the rated R superstar. R. But, like, you know, fucking hell, like, you know, Randy Orton gets a mixed response. Cena, I mean, the jeers get louder every week.
I mean, this week on Raw. Ooh.
Who are they booing more, Eve Torres or John Cena? I don't know.
I mean,
fucking Santino gets more of a pop than fucking Cena or Sheamus, you know?
I know.
This is the guy I want to see as WWE champion, because, I mean, yeah, he is the Dan Hibiki of World Wrestling Entertainment. But the thing is, I would rather see, hear, you know, here is your winner and new WWE champion, Santino Marella. And he come out on SmackDown, you know, wearing the WWE title, and he has a special custom made one for the Cobra around his wrist kind of thing. Come on, you know you want to see that.
That'd be as funny as
fuck. He's got a little mini belt like, wrapped around his wrist, like it's basically like a watch, but it's not the, like, the World Heavyweight title. And he puts the Cobra thing on, and there he is, he's wearing the belt. I mean, come on, that would be hilarious. But no, we got to give it to people like, you know, John Cena, the Cyborg, Randy Orton, the even uglier Cyborg, boring Cody Rhodes.
Oh, don't get me started on that, Tull.
Oh, God, I just...
Thank goodness he's wearing knee pads at last.
Yeah, and it's just like, I mean, whatever spark the WWE had, it is long out now. I mean, they're more concerned, they're not concerned with decent matches, decent characters, they're more concerned with anti-bullying campaigns, sponsorship deals, trending topics on Twitter and all this other shit. I mean, if I see that anti-bullying advert one more fucking time, you know, and do you know what I find kind of ironic? They have these storylines where they're picking on people like, you know, JR, they're picking on people like Hornswoggle, and they're bullying them and whatnot, and they have these anti-bully adverts playing during the press. Isn't that a bit ironic?
Yeah.
Like, here, like, they have a match where, like, they're choking the life out of fucking Hornswoggle, and it cuts a commercial. Bullying is bad, guys. God, man, I miss WCW. I'm actually tending to take Emma's advice and watch TNA. Because, you know, I mean, yeah, I know it's bad. I mean, it's a choice between boredom or suffering, but I just can't.
Madame Distel said there is always an alternative.
Yes, but it's just, it's gotten painful now, and it's just, I don't know why I put myself through. That's why I don't really watch it anymore. I used to watch Raw with you quite a lot. But now, I just don't bother anymore. It's just like, all I really watch of Raw now is just Raw reactions, because there's only so much of that shit I'm willing to try.
I mean, if it wasn't for CM Punk...
I'd give up watching it altogether.
Because CM Punk is... You know, we've said this so many times before, CM Punk is the best thing to happen to WWE since Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Oh, yeah. It's just like,
he is what the company needed.
If I'm to put an analogy or a metaphor on this, right? You remember that bit in The Lion King when Simba came back to Pride Rock?
Yeah.
And it's all a fucking mess, it's tattered, nothing's going on, most of the animals are dead, and Scar's like a tyrannical, like... Almost, I mean, I know people are going to scream Goblin's Law, but considering the hidden undertones of that movie, this applies, you're almost Hitler-like, you know, figure of authority. CM Punk is Simba. and Johnny Ace is Uncle Scar. And I know that's a strange analogy, you're probably thinking, what the fuck? But it kind of fits, because, let's face it, here is a guy who should be on top, but this guy won't get out of the way for him. And he has to basically fight for what is his. And I would, I mean, I know that stupid straight-edge bullshit, I did hate him for that, but now he's being himself, and it's entertaining.
I mean, he is straight-edge, but he's not forcing it on people now.
Yeah, I mean, if I was to sum up, like, Raw, if I was to condense Raw, this is what Raw would sound like. Show begins. The champion! Match. Oh, tremendous impactful maneuver! The champion! The end. That's Raw.
It's funny.
Johnny Ace, Cena, and Michael Solis just talking bollocks!
I mean, it's funny you mention about Michael Cole. Do you know he actually has his lines in front of him when he's at the announce table? He cannot remember his lines. He actually has the script right in front of him on the announce table.
When I eventually descend into the fiery pits of hell, I'm going to be greeted by John Cena, Michael Solis, and John Laurinaitis. They're going to be just... And the thing is, they're going to be, like, waving their merchandise in my face, and then trending live, you're dead, LOL. Just like, I can't. I think I've said enough. I can't deal with this anymore.
I don't know.
It's just, I would rather watch Kickassia several times in multiple languages than put up with Raw right now. It's just, no. Suburban Nights, multiple languages.
Including NetSpeak?
No. And German, Spanish, Swahili. Maybe just play the whole thing backwards to confuse me. While listening to any song by the Spice Girls. That is how much...
Oh, that's rough, man.
That is how much I detest Raw. It's just... I know a lot of people don't watch wrestling. I know Ace is done with WWE now. But it's just...
There's only so much you can take.
There's only so much I'm willing to tolerate. And it's just... I gave up Marvel recently because I recently bought a new batch of comics. I'm like, this is fucking horseshit. Why do I subject myself to this? I mean, the only thing I've got left now is video games. And I'm buggered if video gaming is going to die. Apparently there's this hidden project where Sega, Namco, and Capcom work on a game together.
Mm-hmm.
I already know it's going to be disappointing. I don't care if it's like... Sonic and Mega Man versus Pac-Man at the Winter Olympic World Cup game. I don't care what it is, it's going to suck. Because life is all about disappointment. And, if I look up disappointment in a dictionary, I open the book and the fucking vision of John Laurinaitis naked is going to be standing in front of me, waving his fucking Twitter account in my face.
Oh, that's...
Get the fucking hook! Shucky, ducky, quack, quack. Someone shut this fucker up.
Oh, that's an image I could have done well without.
And with that, I think we're done.
Yes.
Good night, ladies and gentlemen. And before we go, don't forget, trending world live right now. Nah, who cares? Twitter sucks.
I use Twitter, but I don't like it being abused.